But when you say, I want to grow, I want to become more of myself, you know, you put yourself in a position to be sponsored by the universe so that the universe can become more conscious of itself as your life. So that one is intention. Then you have to combine your intention with some level of spiritual practice. There has to be something that you're sacrificing your time around, whether it's prayer, whether it's meditation, you know, whether it's hanging around with high consciousness people and community, whether it's study, whether it's fellowship, some kind of inner discipline. So you combine your intention with some kind of practice, and now you become more of a candidate for the insights that start to take over your life.
So we're going through a psychedelic renaissance right now, where a lot of people are, you know, taking these journeys. But what's interesting is there's also an awareness about the set and the setting. As you said earlier, the set is the intention, the setting is the environment, and it's really beautiful that people are using it as a spiritual practice. So what are your thoughts about that?
I think it's very important that when people are using a psychedelic technology, that the reason why they're doing it is for insight. It's to discover aspects of ourselves, blind spots or potential. To set ourselves free, to become liberated. For hundreds of years, indigenous cultures have used different substances in order to break free from the limited paradigm, the limited points of view. So it's not to be used like a party drug or something like that, and let's go get high and have a great time. It's actually for liberation. And so the set and the setting and the underlying intentionality is extremely important. And if people are coming together under that vibration, then a group energy is created. There's something else that's developed that's beyond the individual that supports everyone going to a higher level. It's like, you know, high tide lifts all boats. So a high frequency that everyone is creating lifts everyone into a greater dynamic. So it's extremely important, the reason why you do a thing.
Well, when we screened the movie in the movie theaters, how we launched it, and again, some of the cities where they had decriminalized psychedelics, like Denver and Portland and in Oregon. It's really great, I think, that they've had a broader initiative to decriminalize all drugs, because look at the people that are getting incarcerated. A lot of times it's people of color, which is really unjust and unfair. But that vibration in the theater, for me, was just really, really, like, you know, spiritual. You know, without marketing, without advertising, you know, we sold seats. And right now it's trending number one on Netflix. So I love the fact that if you can, like you said, tap into that vibration, that frequency, people gravitate towards it, right?
Absolutely. I think there's an intuitive propensity towards activating our potential underneath societal norms and the status quo and pressures we may get from religion or society. There's an impulse, an evolutionary impulse within us that is about revealing our spiritual nature, not religiosity, but our real spiritual nature. So when people come together in the right setting, something breaks free. And so this is what you've discovered, taking it to the movie theater. It's become more of a, it becomes more of a sanctuary of the soul, you know, and people start to remember the insights they have had over the years. And then as individuals mature, they can look back and say, oh, that's what that was. That was my inner self basically guiding me to who I am today, you see. So it's very, very important, yeah.
What's really, you know, amazing too is a lot of people, they cry because, you know, the beauty of nature is so powerful that perhaps it touches the deepest part of their soul. And I feel like maybe it's a homecoming because they're so disconnected from that, you know, their true self. So I love the fact that it can be a catalyst for that, because it's not a sad movie, it's a celebration of nature and the solutions we have. Especially young people came out of the theater too and said they finally have hope, because mycelium can, like, clean the earth, can heal your body, you know, and shift your consciousness.
I think that, you know, as one of the scriptures says, without vision, the people perish. And so many people are bereft of vision. You know, it's not, there's no vision emanating from the political scene at all. There's really no vision in the Justice Department. Medical system is collapsing. There's no vision in society generally. It's all about survival or might makes right. And so when an individual under the psychedelic aegis and spiritual practice can catch a vision of possibility, as you indicated, hope then becomes faith, and then faith becomes conviction. And once someone is convinced of their own spiritual nature, you don't need an authority outside of your own conviction. It's not necessary anymore. And so what happens? You get your power back. You're a sovereign being. And you know that you're connected to something bigger than your body, bigger than your little self, bigger than society. And that gives you a lot of strength, a lot of freedom. And so I'm happy to know that the young people are coming out feeling buzzed, just to use that word, but enthused, you know. And the older people are coming out with probably some deep seeds of remembrance, things that have been covered up for a long time. Say, oh, homecoming, I'm back. This is what it's all about. See, I like to say, you don't do it to get high. You do it to get free. So if you do it to get free, then the addictive behavior doesn't kick in, because your underlying reason is freedom, not escape.